हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर पूजा सिंह। आई एम अ BNYS डॉक्टर एंड करेंटली वर्किंग इन ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डाइजेस्टिबिलिटी ऑफ फूड। सो विल गो टू द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डाइजेशन। सो व्हाट इज डाइजेशन? फूड इज टेकन इन थ्रू द माउथ टू द स्टमक एंड इन टू द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन वेयर इट गेट डाइजेस्टेड। Digestion is the complete breakdown of food so it can be absorbed and used by the body for energy. The digestive process is chewing, the saliva breaks down food, the epiglottis blocks the trachea, muscles push the food down, food mixes with acid, digestion and absorption of nutrients, then waste enters the colon. This was all about digestion. Digestibility is a measure of the degree of net absorption of nutrients in the digestive tract. Carbohydrate, protein and lipids must be degraded to absorbable units, example monosaccharides, amino acid, fatty acids. This is accomplished by the enzymatic hydrolysis of these compounds by digestive enzymes and microflora of the gastrointestinal tract. Digestibility is influenced by several factors related to the treatment and processing of food ingredients and complete diet. An objective studies of this subject have largely centered on two things. That is, number one, emptying time of stomach after various foods have been eaten. Number two, amount of undigested food that appears in stools. So these two are even affected by a number of factors. A food is likely to be classified as difficult of digestion merely because it remains in stomach longer than other foods, whereas it may not be difficult to digest at all. The process of digestion may merely be different and call for a different timing of digestive secretions. The time a food remains in the stomach is not determined by the ease or difficulty of its digestion, but by the nature of the digestive process required to digest a particular food. A food that digests in the stomach in 4 hours is not necessarily more difficult to digest and does not demonstrably use of more energy than the one that digests in 1 hour. It means the digestive process is simply different. The undigested food may appear in stools because the person to whom it is fed is unaccustomed to eating it or has not learned to digest it. It was fed in combinations that prevented its digestion due to fatigue or from any other causes. Pavlov found that the ability to digest a particular kind of food may be increased or decreased by eating that food or by retaining from eating that food. From Pavlov's finding, it is obvious that a vegetarian would have much less digesting ability. For example, the man who regularly and habitually consumes nuts as a part of this diet will have a greater nut digesting ability than the man who seldom or almost never eats. Physiology bears out of the statement that the particular feeding habit produces a particular enzyme or modification of enzymes. A particular composition of body fluids and glandular secretions and particular nerve development. The way to learn to digest a food that is difficult to digest is to continue to eat it. Also, a food that is well digested by an individual at one time under given set of circumstances may be poorly digested by the same individual at another time under different conditions. Carbohydrates usually leave the stomach rapidly, while proteins remain longer. Vegetables containing starch are held up for more thorough digestion. Raw cabbage leaves stomach more quickly than cooked cabbage. Milk rich in fat leaves stomach more slowly than milk low in fat content. Raw milk leaves stomach slowly, pasteurized milk more slowly, and boiled milk still more slowly. So this was about digestibility of food. Thank you.